Good morning and welcome to today's webinar, Predicting Real-World Performance of Your Products with Multiphase Simulation. Okay, we're delighted to have Dr. Sridhar Hari, who's the team lead in multiphysics. I'll give a very brief bio of him. Sridhar was educated at Texas A&M University. His research areas were primarily related to modeling multiphase flows involved in thermohydraulic safety analysis of nuclear reactors. Subsequently, he joined Advanced Methods Development Group, the consulting wing of CDAPCO, and within this area, he provides services to the energy sector, where he works as a technical specialist on multiphysics and multiphase flows. Okay, so with that, it's over to your speaker today, Dr. Sridhar Hari.
We are here to quickly have a high-end overview of the multiphase capability implemented in the STAR CCM Plus code. We'll start off looking at the fact that multiphase flows are everywhere around, and real world physics involves multiphase and multi regimes. Multiphase flow modeling is not anymore a subject of one particular discipline, it spans multiple disciplines. And each and every industry encounters the multiphase flows in some form or the other. Typically, the term phase is usually used to refer to the thermodynamic state of matter, either a solid, a liquid, or gas. But within the CFD framework, multiphase may mean slightly different things. It can mean liquids of different densities, bubbles of different sizes, or solid granules of different sizes and weight. So you can see that the connotations may be different. Within STAR CCM Plus, we have the standard Eulerian Lagrangian or the Euler-Lagrange type of models, as well as Eulerian or the Euler-Euler type of models, in which in the Lagrangian type of models, observer tracks parcels as they move through space and time. There are two different types of models, Lagrangian multiphase, which is called as LMP, and the discrete element model, which is called as a DEM, which is an extension of the Lagrangian multiphase model. Under the Eulerian model, where the observer considers the phases to be continua and they pass through a fixed volume in space and time, we have different types of options. An Eulerian multiphase option, volume of fluid option, fluid film option, mixed multiphase option, and then dispersed multiphase option. We'll see what they are as we go forward. In an Eulerian multiphase model, the phases are supposed to coexist everywhere in the domain, and they are treated as continua, and transport equations are solved for each phase independently. And this type of modeling approach is well suited for problems involving bubble columns, mixing vessels, settling tanks, and such ones. In a typical EMP type of a problem, there is a primary continuous phase, and the secondary continuous phase is dispersed through the primary phase. Mass, momentum, and energy exchange between the phases can be modeled by interactions. The pressure field is the same for all the phases. And the phase in turn may have multiple species or components. Size distributions of particle dispersed phases can be accounted for using S gamma type of a population balance method. And turbulence may be independently resolved for each phase. In the EMP framework, we have two different types of models again when particles are involved as a phase. In problems that involve dense packing, where motion dominates, which is motion dominated, where the motion is dominated by contact and friction, we have a solid pressure force model. And in problems in which motion is dominated by collisions and kinetic energy, we have a granular type of models. These type of models are primarily used in gas solid fluidized simulations. We also have an erosion capability that is actually ported to the EMP capability, which can actually capture erosion that happens because of an impact type of a mechanism and an abrasive wear type of a mechanism. Another example where EMP type of a capability would be used is a typical nuclear boiling water reactor. Here you see 5x5 subassembly of a nuclear reactor, where there are 25 fuel rods and flow actually rises through the fuel rods and gets heated and steam is produced. So the water phase and the steam phases can be separately defined, and then the motion can be tracked and energy exchange can be tracked, accounted for. The volume of fluids framework can also be classified as the broad behavior of what we call as the free surface flows, where there is a clear interface that separates the two phases, and the idea is towards actually dissolving the time-varying features of the interface. It is well suited for problems that involve marine hydrodynamics and seakeeping, sloshing in fuel tanks, and oil and gas flow assurance problems. It's typically used when we have immiscible fluids and the grids are actually capable of resolving the phase interface, and there is no need for you to actually model them, but resolve, because we are trying to resolve here. In the event that there is a surface tension effect that is dominant, the surface tension force can be included. For marine simulations that involve waves, we have a predefined WAF wave capability available in the code. And typical phase change problems involving evaporation condensation, solidification melting, boiling and cavitation can be actually included along with the VOF capability. And here is a simulation which talks about molten steel solidifying inside a cast. There is a typical model called star cast capability that can help you to do such type of problems. We also have something called as a dynamic fluid body interaction capability that can be invoked along with the VOF type of a capability to actually solve problems involving a marine discipline like ships and things like forces on onshore platforms due to the action of waves can be modeled with such a type of a capability. The Lagrangian multiphase capability is called as LMP capability in CCM plus, where the Navier-Stokes equations are solved for the continuous phase and the equations of motions are solved for the parcels of the dispersed phase as they pass through the system. It's very applicable where the volume fraction of the dispersed phase is relatively small and the motion is dominated by interaction with the continuous phase than interaction among themselves. Typical examples involve spray coating, cyclone separation, aerosol dispersion and the like. And within the CCM plus framework, the LMP framework, particle may refer to all the three different types: solid particles, liquid droplets, and gas bubbles. The interaction between continuous and dispersed phases can be modeled using interface forces. We can account for interface mass transfer due to evaporation and condensation or particle reactions, like in a combustion problem. And you can also look about introducing the influence of radiation and convective heat energy transfer. The phases can be coupled either under a one-way coupled or a two-way coupled framework, and you can have an arbitrary number of dispersed phases in the same problem to model. In problems that involve liquid droplets and droplets formed because of evolution through nozzles, a type of primary atomization model called the LISA model is available. And subsequent to the droplet formation, the secondary breakup model tries to attempt or predict the breakup due to the shear forces of the convective field on the droplets. There are various combinations of things that you can choose between, like KHRT, Reich-Debacker, and TAP secondary breakup models, as well as the stochastic secondary droplet breakup model. Once the droplets are transported, the impingement of droplets on the wall can have different outcomes. Those type of a situation can be captured under what we call as a Boyd-Gossman type of a wall impingement model, or a Boyd-Vandenberg type of a wall impingement model. And on problems that involve oil droplets and oil mist separation, a SATO wall impingement model can be actually actuated. And an extension of the Lagrangian multiphase would also allow you to actually invoke erosion models. There are four or five different erosion models available in the code to capture the effect of particles on the walls and the erosion caused because of those. A typical application example for an LLP is actually demonstrated here. It's a spray painting problem on a surface where an overset mesh is actually put on the moving spray arm. It actually sprays droplets. Those droplets impinge on the wall that you saw, on which a fluid film model is actually invoked with a zero thickness at the start, and then the film the paint thickness starts increasing once the arm moves around it. There is also a dispersed multiphase option available within the CCM plus multiphase modeling capability. DMP is an equivalent of continuous phase equivalent of the LMP. Unlike the Eulerian multiphase, in a DMP, the dispersed phase is one-way coupled to the continuous phase. And unlike the Lagrangian multiphase, the dispersed phase behaves as a continuous phase. And because of this reason, things such as droplet rebound and breakup cannot be captured. And typical applications of such type of model is encountered in problems such as aircraft icing and vehicle soiling. And here is a typical case, which is an application example that talks about the droplet capture and formation of a film on a circumferential part of a Boeing 737 nacelle. At different circumferential locations, you can see at 0, 90, and 180 degrees, predictions from star CCM plus compared against experimental values as well as 1D code predictions from Lewis, and you can see that the DMP predictions are fairly accurate and comparable with those other predictions. A dispersed multiphase option can also be invoked in problems that involve automotive soiling and aerospace icing. And here is an example where the windshield wiper motion is modeled with an overset mesh and marked. The DMP and the fluid film options are encoded, and then with time, the formation of a film on the surfaces are captured. This type of a simulation would approximately take 16 hours on a 10-core machine to complete one wiper cycle. A fluid film model is also available under the EMP framework. A fluid film model is invoked when the film thickness is too little for it to be actually resolved, but solved as what happens in a fluid film model is it does not occupy physical volume, but it's represented as a thickness value, and we try to resolve the thickness without through the thickness. And it is used for modeling the distribution of thin layer of fluid on solid surfaces. And it has multiple applications in vehicle soiling, fuel sprays, spray coating, condensation. And here is a typical illustration wherein the droplets impinge on a wing, and then the impinging droplets form a fluid film, which is subjected to convective action by the continuous phase. And you can produce droplets from the film due to action of the waves, convective action, and models like wave stripping and edge stripping models will help you to produce the Lagrangian droplets. Here is another example wherein you can see that the melting and solidification model is invoked in conjunction with the fluid film model, and the fluid film, as soon as it starts forming on the wing, because of very low temperature prevailing on the wings, converts itself to ice. And a typical validation studies have been done. And on the right, you can see that the predictions of a fluid film model compare pretty well with respect to the experiment. And the match is pretty good. The final model that we can think of is a discrete element model, which is more applicable in problems that involve particulate transport where there is interparticle attraction. While the Lagrangian model does not account for the interparticle attraction, interactions, the discrete element model is an extension of the Lagrangian model that takes into account particle-particle interactions and used for problems involving solid or non-run material transport. There are a variety of applications in the mining industry, oil and gas industry, pharmaceutical industry, and agricultural industry where such type of problems are encountered. there are different types of particle types that are available within DEM to cater to the different type of situations that you may encounter in a real world situation. And we'll see each of them in a minute. This illustration shows how ore is actually transported by a conveyor belt and flows through from one part of the plant to the other part of the plant. The DEM allows the user to account for the rotational forces as well as contact forces because of particle-particle interactions. The composite particle option would help the user to make in real-world particles that are not traditionally spherical in nature, and they are rigid, and different types of particles can be actually formed. And there is a typical example where the roller actually pulls out ore from a pit and actually puts it across on a flat surface. And a coarse grain model is available within the DEM framework. The time step and the computation expenditure in DEM is a function of the particle size. And as the particle size gets smaller and smaller, the computation time tremendously increases. To overcome this limitation, the parser type of an approach that we use in LMP can be also used in the DEM approach. And this approach is called as a coarse grain particle approach. Here is a typical example for a fluidized bed where 1.7 billion fine scale particles have been simulated with 100,000 coarse grain parcels. This significantly brings down the computation time, and it takes 7 minutes to simulate 0.1 seconds on 72 CPUs. There are other type of problems where you need flexibility and deformation of the transported phase, and such type of a capability is also possible to be solved using the particle clumps and the parallel bonds model. These particle clumps are deformable, and they can also break once the stress exceeds a particular value of a tensile or a shear stress type of a condition. Here is an illustration that shows how the action of the fluid field moves the particle clump around as well as deforms it. In the latest version of the code, we have also introduced what is called as a cylindrical particle, which was not available so far. Cylindrical particles are very commonly used in a variety of applications. And to create a cylindrical particle, there was a need to actually put together a lot of spherical particles. But with the introduction of this capability, we have made an effort to greatly reduce the computation time. And here are two examples for such a condition where cylindrical particles are used: an auger conveying biomass pellets to a boiler, and a tablet coating problem that is encountered in the pharmaceutical industry that involves cylindrical particles. In a typical multiphase problem, most of the multiphase problems are actually spread over different flow regimes, and we encounter the problem of having to resolve different types of behavior in the different flow regimes. And the multiphase interaction models available within the code help us to actually take care of managing the different flow regimes. In typical problems, the same phase may behave as a continuous phase in one part of the domain and behave as a dispersed phase in some part of the domain. This concept is called as phase inversion under the multiphase framework. And multiphase interaction models would help the user to model this type of problems. If you actually only look at either a EMP type of a framework or a VO type of framework, such type of problems cannot be modeled. But the multiphase interaction models opens up many other difficult problems which are complex in nature that can be approached with this. The first of those is actually what is called as a large-scale interface model, which combines the benefits that you obtain from both the VO type of a behavior and the EMP type of behavior. Here is actually the downcomer of a nuclear reactor where there is a countercurrent flow of air to the liquid, and you can see that with time the shear of the continuous phase actually produces waves that get transported across the domain. And such type of problems, there is no need to go and resolve each minute detail of it, but the LSI model will allow you to capture the overall phenomena in a manner that could be easy from a computational perspective, with different flow regimes like bubbly flow, slug flows, and inverted flows. A typical LSI type of a problem would computationally require significantly lesser amount of cells to resolve the same as you would do otherwise using a VOF type of a framework. This is actually a problem. This is actually a Singapore behavior that you see here. What is actually the droplets that come out of the mouth of the lion actually fall onto the wharf bed in the pond and then coalesce with the wharf bed. So this type of LMP VOF interaction models are available within the code and help you towards looking at applications that involve crankcase and gearbox washing, part dipping coating, rainwater management problems, and dishwasher problems. This is another very important application, a paint dipping application, where the member actually dips through a WAF film, and once it dips through a WAF film and it rises up, a fluid film is actually formed on the member, and as it rises, you can see that the droplets fall off from the member. So modeling this problem would involve invoking a combination of three different models: the WAF model, the fluid film model, and the Lagrangian multiphase model. So the interactions model would allow you to bring in all the three of them together. And in this problem, the simulation took 12 hours on 10 cores. There are typical problems that involve interaction between the Lagrangian multiphase and fluid film. There is a selective catalytic reduction problem where droplets are sprayed. These droplets impinge on the blades and form a film on the blades. There is simultaneous evaporation of the droplets, and the evaporated droplets and the vapor produced from the droplets also undergo a chemical reaction. Such type of problems can also be approached using these interactions. The vehicle soiling problem, where a moving automobile tire on a wet road produces droplets, can also be approached using this capability. And again, there is another application here. There is actually a prevailing fluid film on the road because of rainwater. The rotating tire makes film on the tire, and then the action of shear also starts producing droplets. And such type of droplets produced can also be captured using the LMP fluid film interaction, invoking the wave stripping and edge stripping mechanisms. And in problems where you do not want to actually bring in the LMP type of an approach, we can bring in a DMP type of an approach, and then the DMP and the fluid film interactions can be activated. And a typical car on which the DMP phase starts producing a fluid film on the windshield is a typical example of such a capability. Vehicle soiling, aircraft icing are places where both the LMP type of an approach can be used with the fluid film model, as well as the DMP type of an approach can be used with the fluid film model. So what we have tried to do now is to provide a very, very high-end overview of the different types of models that we have within StarCCM Plus. StarCCM Plus has comprehensive, validated multiphase models that can be looked in from either an Eulerian Lagrangian perspective or an Eulerian perspective. There are two different Lagrangian type of models, Lagrangian multiphase, and the discrete element type of a model. And there are five different Eulerian types of models: Eulerian multiphase, mixer multiphase, WAF, fluid film, and dispersed multiphase models. We also showed that in problems that involve a variety of flow regime transitions, we have interaction models that can help you to capture phase inversion. We also showed a variety of applications on which these type of models have been employed. In addition to this, we have a very strong team, technical team, with a lot of expertise and guidance that can help you to address such type of problems. And for each of the models that you have seen here, we have extensive tutorials that are available, and significant amount of effort has been also put towards validating most of the models that we have in the code. So this is actually a overall summary of the different capability modeling, multiphase modeling capability that is implemented in Star CCM Plus code. Though it is very brief, we have tried our best to actually go through and show you all the different types of things that we have within it, and we will be very happy to answer any questions that you may have at this moment. Thank you for your attention, and we are glad that we could join for the session.
So it just remains for me to say thank you to you all. Thank you to Sridhar. With that, the session is closed. Goodbye.